By adding a sounder to the NSX, you now add the ability to watch for shallow water, additional activities like fishing and diving. So we're going to walk through the setup to make sure you get the best user experience from your sounder. So when adding a traditional echo sounder transducer plugged into the NSX, we can now view those echo features. So to do that, you hit the home button, hit echo, and now you get your echo screen. So on your echo screen, you'll notice some icons. So we do have the ability again to pause it. So if we're taking the vessel out of the water on a lift or on a trailer, we don't want to be transmitting, damage a transducer. We always have the ability to view a full screen and then simply bring it back in. And this is true on any tile, whether it's full page or split. And then we also have the ability to scroll back in time. So you can see that window. You can also grab that window and move it. And this allows us, gives you some time, how far go. We can go tap our screen. And now if we wanted to add a waypoint right there, or if we had an autopilot and wanted to steer back to it, we could hit go to, but you simply hit there. We've now added that waypoint to the screen. And now we also notice that we've got a new icon that gets us back to live data. We also have our plus and minus that can be used for zooming. So what zooming does is it simplifies that picture. So when we're in zoom, we can actually grab that zoom bar and run it up and down through the window. So if we want to explode an area. With zoom, always look at the number and think about whether we're doing a plus or minus. Take the full screen and it's 1/1. So when I hit ×2, that means I basically split the screen in half and I can look at half the screen in this box. If I hit plus and I go to 3, think of it taken down to 1/3 of the screen and so on and so forth. So it allows you to pick a smaller window to expand into this full page. So this is good if you're doing pelagic fishing in a certain water column and you want to see that area expanded, we can go into the zoom. But to get out of it, you'll simply hit the minus until you get down to no zoom and you're back to your full page. So we'll hit the menu, jump in, and you'll notice that it has an advanced mode. Out of the box, it is set to auto mode or a very simplified mode. This is for that beginner, that entry-level user that might not know all of the functions and features of a sounder and doesn't want to get too deep into it. Just let the machine do most of it. So all he's going to be able to do is change his range, whether he puts it in auto, whether he manually ranges. Again, he can go in and select his frequency depending on which transducer he has. It shows you the available frequencies that you can use. So again, we might be in high chirp because we're in shallow water, low chirp or 50 kilohertz if we're in deeper water. And then go in and select some of his custom palettes. So again, it's all personal preference as to what you select, what colors you like. We've got the Lowrance palette. We've got the Simrad palette. So we have different color palettes in there that you can do. And then we also have the ability to bring DownScan overlay onto the sounder. I prefer doing the fish reveal on the DownScan. So if you do have DownScan, I do prefer doing the fish reveal versus down layover scan. But again, it's all personal preference. And in there, when you do turn that on, you have the ability to adjust it right here. And then FishID. So FishID allows us to go and turn on a fish icon, show its depth, bring a beep. So as it sees a target that it shows up as a return that it thinks it's a fish, it's gonna throw an icon and it's gonna beep at you and let you know that there are fish in that area. Now, if you got a user that is more of an advanced user, then we turn on that advanced mode. And when we do that, you notice a lot more things turn on. So that gives us a lot more control over the sounder. So now we get into our individual gain settings. So we have the ability to do auto or manual. In auto mode, we do have the ability to make it more aggressive or less aggressive. So just because it's in auto does not mean it's predefined. We can go and say, basically, when I want to drive, I want to see this style picture, this aggressive on the receive circuit and on the filtering, every range I go through. So that's auto minus 12. But you can change that. You've got your color line. So color is, you know, how do we want hard targets to look like? I can make all or small targets look like they're very hard, or I can go and kind of filter that down. Where some of the higher end users will use this is when they're doing things like tile fishing or looking for a mucky bottom versus a hard bottom. You'll go over a hard bottom surface, you're gonna adjust that to where it's gonna show up as that hard bottom. And then as we go over a sandy or a mucky bottom, you'll notice the color changes from dark red to a lighter red. Now you can do this, you just gotta make sure that you know the difference when you're setting this up of what that hard bottom is so we can tell the difference. But color allows you to adjust how you want those hard target returns, what color you want them to come back as. Scroll speed, so we can increase our scroll speed. So usually when we're in shallow to medium water, leaving it at normal speed is fine. When we start getting into deeper water, we sometimes want to increase that scroll speed. What scroll speed does, as you notice, is what used to be those small fish arch targets are now drawn out long lines. Is because scroll speed, all it's doing is taking the screen and stretching the target to make it jump a further distance. So again, this is when we're in deeper water, we need to see a small target. It's a lot harder to see something down at 12, 1500 feet that's just a dot. So by stretching it out, we get a nice long target, makes it easier to find those targets when you're doing that deep dropping or bottom fishing, sword fishing, stuff like that. It just makes it easier to find a single target in deeper water versus an area where shallow to mid, where you got these nice arches, it's easy to see. So that's where scroll speed comes in handy. Ping speed, again, ping speed is how much sound's going into the water. When would we turn this down? If we start seeing a lot of false returns, we're getting kind of a mirrored image before the bottom, we're getting some bouncing. We're going through and maybe we're doing our cast nets. We don't want as much sound in the water when we're trying to throw that cast net to spook the bait. We can reduce that ping speed so we're not sending out those pulses as fast. TVG, so what TVG is, time varied gain. And what that is a filter for the top 20% of the water. So where do we use this? If we're pelagic fishing, maybe we're tuna fishing, and there's a lot of bait and silt in the water, we wanna slowly filter that out on the top so that we can see the actual tuna that are sitting there fishing or eating within that area. So that's where we would use that time varied gain to filter that top 20-25%. Noise rejection, so this is if you and somebody else are in the same area fishing and you're both using 200 kilohertz or the same frequency, you're gonna get some false echoes, some kind of diagonal lines that will show up on the screen, so you can go into your noise rejection and slowly increase it. Again, you don't wanna always go to high because you don't want to detune some of those fish targets. So just make sure you're setting it to where you need it, not just jumping it up to the max. And then split, so we do have the ability to do a bottom lock. So bottom lock takes the full window, and now what do we want to see? So again, by doing our zoom, we're taking this window and we're doing 1/4 off the bottom. So we're taking, you know, roughly 50 feet, and we're looking out 1/4 of that, 12.5 feet off the floor. So that's 1/4 of the entire window from top to bottom, and just doing it off the bottom. So now if we're bottom fishing, we can see these targets hanging close to the floor. Helps us see them and to separate them. The other one is zoom. So zoom is a variable range zoom. We kind of did that while we were on the screen with the zoom bars, but again, you can take that and run that anywhere. And again, increase or decrease